Here at Pippin's Post Game, wrapping up a tough one tonight for the Pippins. They fall 6-4 in Game 1 in Corvallis. Still very much alive in the playoff hunt alongside Mitch Ellis, one of the guys who certainly was producing tonight. Multi-hit game. A hit from both the left and the right side of the plate. Switch hitter, one of a couple on the team, along with Johnny DeLucan. We've talked about this before, but take me through your approach when you're batting one side. You got to switch over to the left. What was working for you tonight from both sides of the plate?
I just felt comfortable letting the ball get deeper on me tonight. I'd been a bit out in front the last couple of weeks and just trying to make an adjustment.
Yeah, I was going to ask you about that because you've really picked it up of late. I think until a couple days back, you had a streak of 5 or 6 straight games with an RBI, another RBI for you tonight. But is that the main adjustment, just kind of staying as far as spacing with the ball, that type of thing? Or what other things have you done because you've really turned it on now in the last couple of games?
Mainly just focusing on letting it get deep. I mean, I've hit the ball pretty well on the nose this year and just haven't been as lucky and just thought if I just keep sticking with what I'm doing, it's going to pan out in the long run.
Talk to me about the you driving in runs as a run producer. 29 RBIs now, a couple back of Lucas Denny for the team lead. But, I mean, you have been driving them in all season long. There was a stretch there, I think middle of July, wherever it was, where you weren't driving in as many. You were a monster at the beginning, leading the team early on. And now getting going of late, 6 of the last 7 with an RBI. Take me through your approach when you've got guys and runners in scoring position.
It's fun, man. It's easy. Once there's runner in scoring position, it just makes it easier. You just can relax. And as long as you put a ball hard on the nose somewhere, it's going to help the team out. So it's just relaxing once you get up there with that situation.
I got to definitely ask you about the defense tonight. A couple hot shots your way. That spectacular play you made ranging to your left. I don't recall exactly. You might remember which inning it was. Either fifth or sixth, something like that. Yeah, a great play moving your left. You made a nice backhand stab and a hot shot as well. Talk to me about playing the hot corner. I know they had you at shortstop for a bunch of games when Playa was hurt, but is third base kind of your natural position? And what's your approach when you're making those kind of plays at third at the hot corner?
I'd say short's probably my natural position. That's what I played growing up. But I played third base this last year at school and probably a bit more comfortable now over there. But it was nice playing third on the turf tonight. It's Oregon State. You're going to get some good hops. So it was nice. But the sun and the early innings was tough. That was for sure.
What's your approach on balls that are hit that hard? They call it the hot corner for a reason. But when your ball's coming right at you, you barely have time to react. Do you practice just quick reactions, moving gloves a certain way? What's your approach on balls hit that hard?
Yeah, we practice stuff just getting in close and just working your reaction, but nothing really, just staying in your legs. It's once you start bending and trying to reach and get stuff, that's when you're in trouble.
And what's the mindset of this team? You guys are obviously, you haven't clinched yet. You're right on the brink of getting that point where maybe you can get a playoff berth. What's the mindset of the team? Yes, you've lost a couple straight. You're still in a great spot. What are the guys saying to each other, and what does the team have to do moving forward now to get that win and find that playoff berth?
It's a big playoff push for the guys right now. We're just treating every game like a one-game playoff, and the odds were against us there a couple of weeks ago, and we've really turned it on, so we still feel comfortable enough to be able to go get this.
Well, Mitch Ellis has gotten it going. He's going to be a senior next year at Western Illinois. Teammate of Pete Minnella has been playing well as well. The Leathernecks, a good season. It's looking like for next year upcoming. Meanwhile, the Pippins, couple losses in a row here, but a good chance to bounce back tomorrow in Corvallis. Game 2 of the series at 7:05.